Hello guys, I'm back. My name is Jefferson Costa. I'm a chemical process engineer with expertise in plant design. And today I will talk about Aspen High C certification and how you can get that for free. And to do that, I have as a guest my dear friend Akatuidi. And I name it Aka because it's much more easier for me. I am a Portuguese speaker, so thanks a lot, Aka, for being here and in accepting my invitation more than once, because we tried to do this live session in the beginning of the month, but because of my internet connection, we were not able, and now Aka is here with me. And it is very important because to get the certification for free, there is a limited time to do that, and we will explain to you in this live session. And let us know where are you from. We always like to know how far we can reach people in the world. Usually I have a lot of people from India, but I have also from Brazil, from Mexico, and etc. So guys, let us know where are you from. It is important to us. And another thing that I would like to recommend you, if you don't know my Telegram channel in process, I invite you to be part of that, because there is a lot of information on how you get familiar with chemical process engineering and plant design. So Aka, I have some questionnaire here to share with you. And if people has questions in the chat, I will address that to them also. And talk a little bit about you, and after that I will start doing some questions. Okay, thanks a lot.
Hello everyone, hello from India. I know a lot of people from different parts of the world are watching this live session, so thank you all for joining. And I want to thank Jefferson sir for calling me in this live interview session. And I'm really proud to share the same platform with some engineers, known engineers like Vijay sir, Kirit sir, etc. So I am Arka Jyoti Chakravarti. You guys can call me Arka. I know it's a very tough name. I am from eastern part of India, West Bengal. I have done my schooling from my hometown only. And then for graduation purpose, I moved to Chennai, which is in the southern part of India. I have graduated in this year in the field of chemical engineering, and my professional experience in industries is not a lot. I have done some internships in fertilizer industry, in petrochemical industry, but as an intern, not as their intern. So yeah, that's all about me. And do let us know from where are you, and we can discuss these questions with you.
Okay, but we were talking about in the backstage, and you were already selected to start as a process engineer, and it was supposed to be this year, right? But because the COVID, it was postponed, right? Can you talk a little bit about this? Please don't say the company name to not embarrass you, and I don't want that, right?
Okay. So in India, all the grad schools, they have a placement program. So after third year, that means after completion of six semester, different companies come to the college and they for offering the internship. So I sat in one of the renowned companies in India. So the preparation strategy was to sticking to the core and also developing my aptitude. So the core subjects like heat transfer, mass transfer, chemical reaction engineering, fluid mechanics, these all play a major role in the selection process. So the steps was like, there were two steps in the selection. First one was the aptitude with some technical questions. And after that, it was interview was purely technical. In the interview, they will test, tested the proper knowledge, technical core knowledge of the aspirant or the applicant. Yeah, so that's about it.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. And you are a student of mine, and you are in Process Booster, and I'm really happy with that. You get in the first release of my training program, and I hope you like it. And let me know, or let the people know, how did you get in touch with my content, and how long it is?
Okay. Okay, so I joined LinkedIn in my second year of my study in university. So I did not use it at that time properly. I just had one account, that's all. So after third year, I started to check this LinkedIn. I started to review all the technical articles. Those are posted by different engineers who are really successful in their respective fields. So then I came to touch it to your content, and yeah. So in the fifth or sixth semester, that means in the third year only, I came in contact with you, and I really liked those contents and used to download that and review it later, and I gained a lot of knowledge, technical knowledge from those points. So that is the part. That's how I met you through LinkedIn.
Do you remember what was the first post that you saw from me?
It's very difficult now, but it was something related to line sizing or something like that. But I'm not very sure of it. It's
okay. Long. Okay, no problem. And why you decided to join the InProcess Booster? Because I have seen, based in the content that you also share content in the internet, you are a self-learner. But you decided to join my training program, and it is not for free, and it may be a little bit expensive for India economic. And why you decide to join?
Okay, so to answer these questions, I have to share my journey through simulation in different phases. So this as particular software Aspen, I was introduced to it in my fifth semester. There was a webinar in our college organized by our faculty members. So I was really interested in that, and I started reviewing those articles, the study materials provided to us. And in the meantime, I was blessed enough to bag an internship offer in one of the process industries. So after going there, I came to know that my whole project is completely based on simulations. So and that also in Aspen Plus. Then I started to read more and more articles about Aspen Plus. I started to review different kind of YouTube tutorials, and I succeeded to execute the project properly. And so this was till third year. At the final year in major project, one of my friend introduced me to HiSys. He was doing some project in industry, and that involved using of HiSys software. So I sat with him, I tried to learn something, and he also used to discuss with me various aspects of the software. So I was really interested, because to me, HiSys is more user-friendly than Aspen Plus. So both these softwares have different pros and cons to their own, but still, to me, HiSys is more user-friendly. So then I started to begin this learning, the whole part. I referred to some YouTube tutorials or some books, but my approach was not methodical. So after this COVID situation, we all, our life came to a standstill. So I used to use this LinkedIn a lot for my learning purpose. There I came across this InProcess Booster program through a webinar. So after going through the syllabus, I was really happy to see all those modules covered, and it was really a methodical approach, which I was lacking during my preparation. So I just wanted to learn the software a lot. So I just joined your program, and I do not regret it now. And it is so methodical. The contents are really high quality, and that helped to bring my confidence in, build up my confidence in this software. And now I am really confident in using this. And I use HiSys once or twice a week regularly to simulate my models or experiment something.
Okay.
So this is the whole story.
Thanks. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot for your feedback. And guys, I didn't see any comments in the chat. Please participate with us. We have around 30 people here, as I can see, or 25. And it's very important that you participate, because if you have questions, I will address that to Arca, and let's see how we can help you also, okay? So, Arca, what is Aspen HiSys user certification, And if you have a presentation to share with us, feel free to do that. Let me allow you to do that.
Thank you guys for hanging in with us because we are very sorry for this delay or this inconvenience. So let's start again. Before going to the HICE certification, I'll just tell about the general Aspentech certification and what are the softwares available for certification. So what is Aspentech certification? It is an online certification exam. It tests your competency in using various software that are offered by Aspentech. So you have Capital Cost Estimator, DMC3, IP21, GTOT, HICIS Plus. Even in some softwares, you are getting expert user certification as well, like Aspen Plus or Aspen HICIS or Aspen PIMS. So you can go through this certification exam. Now, coming to the HICIS certification exam, it tests our competency in using the HICIS software. So there are total four scopes, like you have to know the how to handle the properties environment, and after that, how to develop flow sheets, and also how to use the unit operations block, what are the basics of unit operations, the degrees of freedom, et cetera, et cetera. Also, you have to know different advanced topics like flow assurance studies, column hydraulic analysis. Different use of different manipulators like adjust, recycle, balance, etc. Those will be tested in this exam. Also, some troubleshooting in HICIS is also there in the syllabus. Though the target audience are process engineers and facilities engineers, but anyone who knows this software or those who use this software in day-to-day basis can apply for the exam and get certified. So let me go through the exam details now. So the format of the exam is multiple choice questions and lab. There are two parts of the exam. First part consists of 40 multiple choice questions. And the second part consists of 16 questions. Those are virtual lab. Now this certificate is valid for 3 years. And the exam duration is 4 hours. Though this is a very long time, you won't need 4 hours if you are very much competent with the software. You can finish within two and a half hours as well. Now, I told that there are total 56 questions. 40 of them will be from multiple choice, and the rest will be from the lab part. So this MCQ part contains 40% of the marks, pardon me, and the lab part contains 60% of the total marks. So to get certified, you have to achieve the 70%, the passing score. And the level of the exam is moderate. For those who are expert user of HICIS, they can apply for the expert user certification exam. It will involve some different topics like hydraulics, compressor surge, surge analysis, all those different subflow sheets, those are available inside the software. And also HICIS dynamics and oil manager, those will be the essential part of the expert user certification exam, not in the basic level, that means the user certification. So let us discuss about the step-by-step approach of this exam. So now, first step is to go to the website and visit this website. I have given the link here. You can go to this website, take different exams that you are competent with the software. You can take these exams. And now after that, you have to verify all the details, like what is the exam syllabus, what you have to know, or how should you prepare, etc., etc. So you have to verify all the details will be available in the website as well. And now, for the preparation, the Aspentech obviously provides training program, but this is not mandatory for giving the exam. If you know HICIS or you use HICIS software in day-to-day basis, you can easily appear for that. No training program is necessary. And after that, you have to fix the exam schedule. You have to choose the date, location, time. There will be available in the website only. And I prefer that you choose according to your time zone. Like if you're from India or Asia, you choose the Asia Pacific server only, because that will lead some smooth experience of the exam. Otherwise, if you're from Asia or you choose the American server or the USA server, then your experience will be somewhat laggy. So I will advise you to choose the server that in your time zone or your area. Now, for the fee payment, now for some days, the Aspentec is giving free certification exam. They're giving away this thing. But after that period, if you don't have any license or your company does not have any license, you have to pay a certain amount of fee, which is $150. And after that, you can register the exam. But if your company allows or your company has the license, most of the cases, the exam will be free only. Now, after the registering, you have to check your mail, which you have given in the website, because Aspentec will be contacting you in various ways, like they will arrange meetings before the exam. So you have to check your mail regularly and follow the updates sent by them. Now, yeah, so all done. After that, after registering, you can start your preparation. And for the preparation material, I will cover this at a later part. Now, coming to the scope of the exam, I have given the link of the syllabus here. You can go to the website and download that as well. But briefly, I'll explain. So the first scope is to analyze your competency in the properties environment. So you have to know what are the default component list available in the software, what are the package, which thermodynamic package is by default is assigned to HYSYS. Or like petroleum assets asset management, like oil manager, and their ASTM, D26, etc., D116 analysis, all those things will be there. Now, after properties environment, you have simulation environment. So there, you have to build a flow sheet. You have to know that how to build a flow sheet, or how to use different unit operation or unit processes available in HYSYS. What are the inputs, what are the outputs, etc. Not only this, you have to know different manipulators, like adjust, set, balance, those things you have to know. How to use that, what are the methods those particular blocks are using, etc. Now, coming to the reporting part, you have to know what are the different reporting options, like HYSYS workbook, common reporting options, etc. Also, you have in the unit operations block, there is a particular tab called worksheet. You can report data from that as well. So these things will be covering the MCQ part of the exam. Like they will ask, what are the different types of reporting? They will give some options. You have to choose the correct one. Now, coming to the troubleshooting part, this is you have to do a little bit of troubleshooting, like you have to handle the consistency errors. What are the flow sheet errors? When the solver is active, when the solver is on hold. So you have to know these things. Yeah, so that's about the scope of the exam. This is a very brief part for the elaborated syllabus. You can always download that from this link, and there you will be having the elaborated part. I mean, what are the different parts of the exam? It will be given very extensively. So now, as I told that 40% will be from the MCQ part, and the 60% will be virtual lab. So MCQs, I have explained it a little bit, but in the next slide, I'll give you some examples as well. And in the virtual lab, will be given to simulate a proper plant, like they'll be giving you natural gas processing plant or some fermentation plant. You'll be given all the input data, like stream properties, what are the blocks available, what are the recycle streams, block property, etc. will be given all of those. You just have to build the flow sheet, and based on the results of the simulation, you'll be asked questions. Like if you simulated distillation tower, then the question will be like, what will be the reboiler duty? They will give four options. The options are like kind of range, like 5 megawatt to 6 megawatt. You have to choose between, your simulation results will be in between those two options. You have to choose that. Like that, you'll be asked, like, what will be the steam consumption in the reboiler? What are the utilities can be used? So these will be covering the virtual lab part. So one more important thing I want to mention, that you don't have to have the software within your system. You'll be given access remotely to their computers or their systems, and you'll be using their software. So only you need a good internet connection and low latency. Otherwise, and that's it. You will be very free to use the exam. Now, let us discuss about the MCQ part. I'll give some examples and you can expect some questions from here as well. So like you have to know about the HiSys UI, user interface, like what are the different sections available, what is navigation pane, what is called zoom slider. So they will ask in the MCQ part like this type of question. They will give some image and they will ask that what is this window called. So you have to know these things. And before I forget to mention that, the HiSys help will be available to you throughout the exam. So if you get stuck in any question, you can always refer to HiSys help. But you should not completely rely on that because some questions are like basic general knowledge type questions. Those will not be available in the help part. So you have to be prepared before appearing in the exam. But to support you, there will be HiSys help. And that is a vast material or vast source of information that you can know about the software. So second thing is like different types of file extensions. Like what is .fpk? Like they will ask, FlowShift file extension is, they will give four options. You have to choose the correct option. Like for example, .fpk is fluid package extension. CML is component list extension. .hfl is the FlowSheet extension. .afam is the oil manager extension. .ppl is the template extension. So there are different types of extensions that you should know because MCQ will come from that part. Now, like the how many ways you can select your components. So there are two ways, like HiSys data bank is there and Aspen properties is that is also there. So you can choose from both of the data banks. So there are two ways to select your components. Like what are the different property package sources? So there are three sources: HiSys, Aspen Properties, COMTHUN. These are all expected questions, MCQ questions. So if you go through this part or go through the HiSys help, you will be knowing all these answers. Now, different types of flows and their differences. What is standard ideal liquid volume flow? Actual volume flow, liquid flow at standard condition. What is the basic difference between them? So you have to know that. Now, what are the stream analysis options available? So you know that in any particular stream, there will be an option called stream analysis. There you can plot PTN plot, you can choose line sizing. So there are various options available. So you should know what are the various options. So this questions you don't have to remember. Like suppose this question comes up, what are the various stream analysis options available? So you have the HiSys software, you can just plot a stream and go to the stream analysis part, you can check the options. So you can count the number and give the answer. So you have to play strategically that what I have to remember, what I don't have to remember. Like if you prepare strategically, then it is a very easy exam. Now, what are the various models available for VTEX? In my case, there are, I mean, a number of questions from VTEX Ninja games, like the properties of each model. Suppose for phase change, which model you have to use? Simple weighted is very, is generally used for phase change, like condensing steam. Simple endpoint, it uses constant UA method to solve this thing. So this information will be written in the help section. You can just go through this part and you will be knowing all these properties of this model. I have just given example for VTEX. So you will be having for all the models, the information will be loaded in the HiSys help. So if you go through those HiSys help once before the exam, you will be knowing that if suppose this question comes, then I know that this answer will be in this part. So it will take less time to check the help menu if you are not very familiar with the answer. Now, what are the different specifications you can give for heat exchanger model? Like you can give six specifications: production temperature, LMTD, overall UA, approach, minimum approach, etc. So you can just go through those. Different, what are the different methods or reporting methods? You can check material stream, you can check worksheet in the unit operations block, you can check HiSys workgroup, spreadsheet can be linked with the software as well. Now, so what are the function of recycle advisor? This is a very important topic. Like, there is an option called recycle advisor. Suppose you have three or four recycle streams in your flowsheet. So how recycle advisor is going to help you? It will just suggest you the minimum number of recycles and it will be adjusting it on its own. So you don't have to think about this day, which recycle should I should delete, which one I should keep like that. So you can just click on Recycle Advisor. It will tell you that you will need two minimum of two recycle dishes, other two you can delete. So you should know this. And also, what are the proper locations of the recycle block? Like you will have minimum recycle number of recycle streams. You have recycle block at the downstream of a mixer or the upstream of a distributor. So this small things you have to know. Also very important, what are the different calculation modes? Like there are different convergence modes, different acceleration modes like Wittgenstein, or in convergence mode there are Newton's method, second method. So you have to know that which methods are available in for a particular block. Now also multiphase flow model and their applicability, you can go through the pipeline segment and go to the help. You can check, there are different flow models like TULSA unified models or Diggs and Brill method. So they can be applied for a different, I mean, for a particular condition. Suppose that condition does not match, then you cannot apply Diggs and Brill method. You have to go for some other method. So what are the applications? I mean, what are the, I'm just losing the word. So this multiphase flow model you have to study. And for the column plates, different column templates are there. So you know that absorber is there, the boiled absorber is there. So complete distillation column is there. So you have to know that. Also, their degree of freedom. So if you have a absorber, there will be degree of freedom will be zero. Then if you add a total condenser, it will increase by one. If you add partial condenser, then the degree of freedom will be two. So you have to know for different cases. What is the degree of freedom for the particular model? So these are some example questions. So now I will tell you about the preparation plan and how I prepared for the exam. So after registering, I had around 2 weeks before the exam. So that time I completely relied on some textbooks, HiSysHelp, which includes HiSysHelp obviously, and also as I am a member of In Process Booster. Though those study materials provided by Jefferson sir also really helped me a lot. So maximum I depended on this for simulation practice and simulation models. And for MCQ part, I used various two or three textbooks just to go through, not all the part. And also I extensively used the HiSysHelp because that is the main part. I mean, that will be having much more information than any other textbook for the examination purpose. And also, if you want to enroll in AspenTech training program, it's available. Also, you have to enroll for that by giving some fees. So just keep in mind, keep that in mind. And for HiSys certification, this particular user certification, you have to refer EHY101. This course you have to refer. So the syllabus of this exam will be covered in this course only. It is available virtual or it is available in person. So based on your convenience, you can apply for it. Now, again, as I told that my preparation was completely for simulation models and practice, I completely relied on in-process booster tutorials. And for that, I really want to thank sir for providing us such useful content. And the other sources was like 20% I used this textbook, HiSysHelp, and the documents, different documents from the internet. So now I just want to give two or three suggestions for this preparation and also for the smooth experience of the exam. So first one is you have to check your mail regularly because they'll be sending updates. They'll be you'll be meeting your proctor virtually just before the exam. So they'll clear all your doubts like what are the do's and don'ts during the exam, what you should do. You should not refresh the browser. You should always keep track with the answers in a Word file. So those things will be declared during this virtual meeting before exam. Now, know the components of the exam. That means you have two components. There are WebEx, which will be the software like Zoom. It will be monitoring you, and the CloudShare platform. CloudShare is nothing but it will be remotely given access to their system because so all of us don't have high system. So some of us don't have high system, so you have to give the exam in their system only, but you will be given access remotely. So again, you have to crack this exam, only 60% is virtual lab. So the 10 additional 10 marks will be gaining from the MCQ only. So I will suggest you to know the HYSYS theory, know the basic facts about HYSYS apart from the simulation. Also take advantage of the helpmen inside the software before appearing the exam. Because if you, I mean, if you don't prepare for the exam thinking that I have this HYSYS help, I can use that. But it will take much more time to solve this exam. The simulation part is somewhat lengthy, so you will need time to complete that problem. So I will suggest you to go through the help menu properly before appearing the exam. Also, prepare well for the proctored exam and read the questions carefully in the lab section. In the question, they will be giving some hints and some tips and tricks to solve your problem, to convert your simulation. Mainly in the EDR browser, like sometimes heat exchangers does not want to converge because of the complexity. Then they will give, they'll be giving hints like use the standard method, change the acceleration method. So take those hints and try to finish the simulation problem. Always save your simulation during the exam because we don't know when our internet will be an issue. So just do something, I mean, do some part of the simulation, save that. Save that on the desktop. And again, start doing the new things then. So save your simulation during the exam exam time. It will be very helpful to you if your internet shuts down or it will not, if you face some issue. So yeah, that's it. Thank you, sir, for the presentation, for giving me the opportunity to present this thing. And yeah, my presentation is over. I'll stop here.
Thanks a lot, Arka Duiti. Thanks a lot, Arka. And let me open again my preliminary. Let me open again my preliminary questionnaire. Just a moment, please.
I just wanted to say that people who are watching, if you have some questions that is not covered in the presentation, please go ahead and ask in the comment section. I'll be happy to answer all your doubts.
Yeah, I think if you don't mind that we schedule another live session just to question and answers, because for some reason it stopped again. But I will not. I would like not to stop our meeting. Let's proceed with that, and I have some questions to ask you. And once we finish that, I will do the edition. I will let it available for everyone in my YouTube channel, and I will update all the links and stuff like that. And we can schedule a live session only to answer any questions, if you don't mind. What do you think?
Yeah, it's fine.
Okay, let's go to our first. And the first thing in your presentation, you shared with us what is the Aspen HYSYS user certification. You talked about the step by step to subscribe and do the certification. That was very nice. And currently, because the COVID, they are providing a coupon to have the license for free, right? But currently, in normal, it is a paid certification for outsiders of for those ones that doesn't have the license, right? But if the person works in a company that have the license, and we are not talking about an official license, we are talking about the official license, it can get for free, right? The certification if he passed the test.
Okay. Then that particular person has to approach through the company.
You don't go directly to the ISPIN. We talk to the company. Is that?
To avail the free exam. Because we don't have, I mean, the person does not have the license. The company has the license, right? So
yes.
The person has to go through the company.
Okay, and you did the certification, and you are ready to start a job in the in the next year. I'm very, very happy about this news, and it's always rewarding when I see my students getting further in their career. For sure, I am very, very happy, and you know that you can count on me if you have any issues related to your new job. Okay, I'll do my best to help you. And besides that, what are your plans? You need, you think to do a master? You think to keep it only with job and do specific courses? What are you planning for 2021? Because 2020, it's almost over, right?
Over, right. So I have not given a thought about doing masters at this stage. But for sure, I'll be joining some industry in the for the next 2-3 years, because I want to gain the industrial experience, how the industry works actually, being in the industry. That's I just want to do that. But for masters, that I have not decided yet. After gaining some experience, if I think that masters is necessary for me to go ahead in my career, then I will obviously do that, but I have not given a thought at this current stage. But for sure, I'll be joining industry. I'll be gaining industrial experience in the next year or coming 2 or 3 years.
Nice. And I have seen some people that has a master, but they have a master because they finished their studies, and as they sometimes they don't have work and they start a master just to not get stop it in between the graduation and get a job. And but it seems that could be interesting to you if you are interested, of course. And I have seen that you study a lot and you are self-learning. Look for the shattered certification, and I'm pretty sure that in a few years you are able to get that, because it seems that in Brazil, we don't have this kind of culture, okay, of shattering, but I have seen that in Europe and also in the India, it seems that it's a value for some people. And it's more about having something to show that you were certified, but in the knowledge by itself, we don't need any kind of certification, right? You just need to have results. The most important than certification is results. It doesn't matter if you have an Aspen High C certification, if you don't know what to do with that, what to do with the results of Aspen High C's, how to start a project if you are looking for working with plan design, how to develop a project and how to finish a project. The Aspen High C certification will be not of much help if you don't have the whole point of view, the whole vision of the plan design is. And I talk about plan design because my main mission is to help people learn how to do plan design. And ARCAD knows that the process simulation is just a small part of the plan design, right?
Exactly, sir. So this is just maybe 20% or 25%. After that, we have to match those simulation results with the calculated, hand-calculated results. We have to verify those. After that, we have to prepare the documents, PNIDs, and all. So it's a huge part. And yeah, you're absolutely right. And also, I mean, the graduates, or we all know a small part of this. And what is happening after that, that will be only possible if I join an industry or gain some industrial experience. That will help us in knowing the further parts like process data sheet preparation, PNID preparation, the reading and all. So.
And you said about the statistics, and I was very surprised about the 80% help about in process boost. Can you explain me or give me a better vision about what is this 80%?
Okay, so as I told that there are 60% weightage to simulation, virtual lab exam. So to execute the simulation, you have to know the HiSeq software, right? So how to use those models, what are the inputs, how to manipulate all those things. So for that, you need a certain training to solve those. If you don't know HiSys, if you're a beginner to HiSys. So I was a beginner to HiSys in March 2020. Now I feel more confident in using HiSys because of the in-process booster training program that offers us, like graduates, a methodical approach to this, to learn this software. So that's why I told that the major knowledge I gained from in-process booster and the other things like the theoretical part that is covered in different textbooks or HiSys. Because so that's about it. That's how I estimated that 80%.
Okay. Very nice to know that it was worth to you. And Aka, we are some minutes talking and we had a lot of issues in this live session. Again, I'm so sorry for that. I don't know what's happening. And please let share with us a final message. And I hope that I will find you soon. And as I talk to you, I plan to have a Q&A live session just to clarify any issues that people have about the subject, because the issue that we faced now between the YouTube and my stream software. So please, what is your final session and enjoy your Saturday night in India.
Thank you. So before going, I just want to address the people who are students who are graduating this year. So we are in large number, and maybe because of this situation, this unprecedented situation, we don't know what plays ahead in our future. So I'll just tell them to just hang in there, build on your skills, work on that, learn new things, and build your technical knowledge. And yeah, hang in there. Maybe good times are ahead. Much more good times are ahead of us. That's
okay.
All. That's what
okay.
I wanted to say.
Thanks, Aka. And I will like just to a final message. People say that industry don't like freshers, and that may be right. That may be wrong. But in fact, it is possible to get a job position if you dedicate yourself enough to get that. And if you not give up, Aka is an example of it. He finished his graduation. It was in the earlier days right now. So he is a fresher and he got opportunity. So you must not give up, and you will find your opportunity soon. Okay, Aka, thanks a lot, my friend. And see you soon in the next live session.
Thank you, sir. Goodbye.
Bye. Hello guys, I'm back. My live session with Aka is finished, but before ending this video, I would like to share with you how is the procedure that you should do in the Aspen Tech website. And just to show you the links, the options, in order that you have any kind of issues when you are doing your registration. And it's very important to you know that there is a limited time to get the Aspen HiSys for free if you are not if you don't have a Aspen software official license. So I will show you how to you can add a coupon, and with that, even though you don't have the Aspen license, you can get the opportunity to have the Aspen HiSys certification. So this is the Aspen Tech website to do the registration to the Aspen HiSys user certification, and the link will be available in the description of this video, and it is the esupport.aspentech.com/certification-home, and in this website you will have information from all products where the Aspen Tech provides certification, and you have seen this during the Aka presentation. And as we are interested in Aspen HiSys user certification, I will click on Aspen HiSys user certification, and you have some general information about that, and most of it we have seen during the presentation. and it has some recommendation for preparation, and it is available to you, the study guide. And in the study guide, you will be able to get familiar with the content of the Aspen High C User Certification. So it is a 9-page workbook. So there are a lot of information here, the topics, and etc. And you can download this guide, and it is a free guide. You can download it from the Telegram channel in process. If you go to my Telegram channel, you are able to get that, to get it now, okay? So it will help you, but there are other sources of information that you should take a look. And to do the registration for the exam, you must choose the server that best fits to you, and as Aka said, try to choose the one that is located in your region, because with that you will avoid problem with lagging, and you don't need to have the Aspen High C software in your computer, because you will use a virtual Aspen High C from the cloud of Aspen Tech. And there are many options here, and you have the date, and you have the link to register. So just for example, I will choose the first one, and if I click on register, I will go to another page. And just to let you know, the standard price for Aspen certification is $150. Once you click on registration, you will be transferred to this web page, and you will see that there are information related to the registration exam, and the price is $150. So there is no discount, and if you click on checkout, you need to provide information to pay this amount. But if you use the promotional codes, and it is available only because the COVID pandemic issue, you can have a 100% discount in this price. So if you type free ACU and I click on apply promotion, you can see that we have a discount, the same value as the standard price, and with that the subtotal goes to zero. And with this you can do, and you can schedule your Aspen certification, user certification, for free. And you can try to do the same for the others application, but make sure that you are prepared to do that, because if you don't do that, it will be a waste of time. So this is it, my friend. I hope you liked this live session. We had a lot of issues in this live session. I don't know why, but with this video, I believe that you are better prepared to get your Aspen registration. And if you get this promotion period, you can do that for free if you don't have the official license. I will let some material available in my Telegram channel in process, and I invite you to join it if you want to know more about chemical process engineering and plant design, because there are a lot of content there available to you. So my name is Jefferson Costa. I'm a chemical process engineer with expertise in plant design, and I'll see you soon in the next video. Bye bye.